Now, Claire's date leaves her cold in Shortland Street.
It's like you want us to get caught or something.
Isn't that always the best way?
Take me back to your place now.
I can't.
I'll show you just how grown up I can be. Call me. My phone's always on.
It's late, I should go. Do you mind dropping me home?
Of course not.
I've got to go.
What? Why?
Sarah needs me.
Get in.
Wait.
I'm not in the mood for teasing.
I'm not teasing, I just don't want to do it in your car.
Hey, if you're not keen, it's fine. I drive you home.
No, it's either at your place or not at all.
What's your problem? I thought you wanted some excitement in your life.
Yeah, not like this.
Hey, you texted me first, babe. I thought you were more than keen. You know what? You should be more careful. You're just a kid.
Yeah, well, that didn't bother you when you were snogging me at the wedding. And what about all the flirting and the looks?
It was a mistake. I let my feelings get in the way.
Yeah, well, they still can. Back at your place.
Nah. The moment's passed.
What are you doing?
Being a friend. Evie, it's Mark. What are you up to? Now you feel like a visitor? I'll see you then.
Laters.
You can't walk from here.
Watch me.
Claire, it's dangerous. I'll give you a ride.
I can look after myself. Just remember that.
I thought you'd gone home.
Well, I came back, obviously. I need this to get through the independent DHB report, all that red tape.
Yeah, tell me about it. I used to work for social services.
You want one?
Sure.
To the district health board.
Here, here.
Oh, that's a nice drop.
Yeah, it's leftover from Victor Kahu's days. I'm not much of a drinker myself.
Yeah, I was at your stag do, remember? Yeah, I'm sorry. I probably don't want to be reminded there was wedding and everything.
I just came from seeing Sarah. Or trying to see Sarah.
Doesn't want a bar of you?
No, not tonight. Earlier on today it seemed okay. I felt like there was something salvageable. But now it's... No. It's over.
Why, just like that? You're giving up?
I don't have a lot of choice. She feels totally betrayed.
You made one mistake. That's all it was. I mean, deep down, Sarah knows that. So don't take no for an answer. It's time for the second phase.
The second phase?
Tactics. First, you clear all the obstacles out of your way. And second, you ask yourself what's Sarah's greatest fear, and you take it away from her.
Sarah's not afraid of anything.
Being alone? Keeping us unsafe? She's a solo mum now, that's hard.
No, I'm not like that.
Look, you want her back? And play hard. You're going to lose everything.
Okay, I'm listening.
Right. Obstacles. The carrot top.
Robin.
We need to deal with her first.
I've been through my contract and I get most of it. Homework, assignments, curfews.
Mm-hmm. All perfectly reasonable.
Yeah, but about the Etty thing, you know, not being able to see him without being supervised.
Yes.
I was just wondering, is Jake a suitable supervisor?
No. No way am I going to stand around while you two suck face.
Jake, I should be the one getting the car.
You don't deserve a car.
You're rewarding it for misbehaviour. By that logic, I should have a house.
Besides, it's not a car at this stage, okay? It's just a promise. Scarlett has to fulfil her side of the contract first.
Well, where's my contract? I promise not to see Etty either.
Grow up, Jake.
Anyway, rather buy my own car than be treated like a monkey.
A monkey with a car goes further than you on a pushback.
I just thought I'd let you know I'm seeing social services at 2 o'clock today.
Right.
So I'll speak to you afterwards.
Yeah, okay.
Ah, hello again.
What a pleasant surprise. It's always so great to see you in the hospital.
I saw you and Claire and Coltrane the other night. I couldn't help but notice how quickly you whisked her away.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, she's very young, but maybe she's not a lesbian. Speaking of... Shame, really. Claire and I used to be so close. She used to tell me everything. Which is how I knew where you and she were going to be that very first night you went out all those months ago. You know, when Andrew got there just in the nick of time.
You told him.
And I really don't want to make a habit of dobbing you in. So be nice, won't you?
If you had any decency, you'd tell her where to go.
My business, Claire.
You're a creep.
Finally, I get to talk to you. Look, all I want is a chance to explain properly.
All right. My office.
Yeah, my dad used to give me the belt, and I give my daughter a car, and it works just as well.
Yeah, what did I tell you? Now everyone knows about Dr. Godfrey, the locum covering for Sarah.
Yeah, he's in today, isn't he?
Godfrey? Lawrence Godfrey. You know him? One of the best doctors I've ever worked with. But no-nonsense attitude gets the job done. One of Australasia's top cardiothoracic surgeons.
Yeah, I know. I've read his work. How did you manage to snag him? I would have thought that Lawrence Godfrey was above covering in a little old emergency department.
Well, I just rang the temp agency.
That's a bit odd.
We've got a bit of work to do to make sure we're up to scratch.
Everything's fine, Judy.
Maya, all points check. I'll brief the nursing staff.
He's just a locum.
Look, I'm not trying to make life difficult for you.
Too late.
Oh, Andrew.
No more games, Robin. What do you want?
A new start. To put what happened with Caleb behind me and to look forward to a future with my child. Our child.
And what's that got to do with me? I never wanted to have another child with you.
But that's the whole reason we made love that afternoon.
Your whole reason, obviously. I was stupid enough to believe that it was our last goodbye. I thought it meant that I'd never have to see you again.
I only wanted to keep you informed of the situation. To give you the opportunity to know your son or daughter.
Well, I don't want to.
Right. Well, now that we've got that clarified, I'll just go back to London. You don't trust me at all, do you? Remember my friend Chloe and her partner Jules? Well, they've said I can stay with them even after the baby's born. They've got plenty of room and an amazing nanny who's really looking forward to looking after another little one.
Well, you're all sorted then.
Well, as long as you don't mind the fact that your child is growing up on the other side of the world. I'll be leaving in a couple of days. In case I don't see you around, I'll say my goodbyes now. I'll send you a copy of the birth notice when the baby arrives.
She get the message?
Yeah, she's going back to the UK.
Excellent.
You all right?
It wasn't easy. She's pregnant with my kid.
And you got a brand new wife to win back, so forget about Robin. Out of sight, out of mind, yeah?